Thank you. it's like risky to take a walk because he sits there and stares at you, even though I've actually lived in this neighborhood my entire freaking life. And he hasn't. He's like, I got you on camera. You're on my camera. What are you going to say? Live around here? I didn't answer. I'm like, that's none of your business, dude. You're allowed to take a walk on the sidewalk. It's public property. It's not your property, and there's no fucking curfew for an adult in the United States. Jesus, land of the free my ass when you got people like George Zimmerman looking to shove a gun up your ass every time you take a walk. Anyway, I'm gonna walk at one. I'm gonna keep walking by his house till he probably does pull a gun on me because he's fucking thinks that there's people, as he said, prowling around. All Hammerlock side missions. All name locations. Yeah, side missions and name locations. That's it. That slagged. Poisoned Warrior. Feels like this DLC should give you more Iridium. We're not going to come out of this thing rich at all. And it's an expensive DLC for Iridium, too. Both raid bosses require you throw it in there. We could probably kill the big-ass Strider thing, though. Since we were able to do damage to Vermnivorous, I don't think it's outside of the realm of possibility being able to kill the Strider. Wish I knew what this game considered long-range rocket kills. We don't have that skin. Oh, we better get it. I wonder if this is any good. We still need some- it's all pity. Long way back. Hopefully, it's 100%. We're gonna have to backtrack. It's gonna be some of the quest that was in this area that I didn't pay any attention to. This fucking guy. This guy right here. See ya. It's too bad they got rid of explosive damage though. Like, kinetic, though, I think, like, explosive stuff is still kind of going to be in there, but anything with a non-element is kinetic. So maybe explosive's still in there, it's just not considered an element. place looks so gray, man. We'll be sick of it by the time it's over with. Explosive. That was way harder for me to understand than it should have been. So probably hit 50 right here. I must say those pheromones. Prepare for us to fuck stuff up. I'm gonna try to do this again. We have to be very careful now, though, because we're gonna destroy this thing. Lock it off. So the thing about this is it's gonna scale. It's DLC scale. I think all the DLC scale. Let's see if Marcus does the same. Okay, if I crash here. Alright, so that makes more sense. I'll still be curious what it's like. What it's like. I'm still gonna miss explosions. Like, I still hope that there's. So that would mean just an AoE kinetic gun. So a non-elemental gun with splash damage would be basically what explosive used to be. It just won't have a modifier to it. This is gonna hit so hard now. I'm confident we're probably doing enough damage at this point that we could kill the big ass Strider Raid boss.
My toxic!
Yes, sweet. That'll be interesting. That'll be interesting for sure. That's all explosive was in 1-2. What do you mean? Like, here it's like, you know, Tor gets an element. Well, it changes between 1 and 2 in that, like, in 2 it's, like, actually fucking, like, missiles and shit. Where in 1, it's, like, all the other elements. Like, you still shoot normal bullets, but you explode people. Maybe I'm still misunderstanding. There's a really good chance of that. Alright, we cannot kill this fucker this time. We keep killing him. Still trying to get those long range rocket kills so we can unlock that challenge accepted thing. Spread your damage to a bigger area. Okay, well, I agree with you there. I see what you're saying there, but it's still considered an element, right? I mean, especially Borderlands 1, where it's like fire. It works exactly like fire and shock. Like, there's a chance to apply the explosive effect, you know, and then they get chunked. And then, too, where they're like the bullets themselves are explosive. Elemental unkept heralds. You've been keeping up to date on it, Ashton. Damn, I didn't realize you were staying this up to date on it. Now you can do the big AoE ranges and get bonus from the elements. Alright, so that part now makes sense, finally. As I said, it was harder to understand than what it should have been, but that's not unusual for me. It's a way of life. That just didn't respawn. That's weird. I'd kill for some fire Maggies. I'm just glad the Masher's coming back. I honestly am not a big fan of the Maggie, just because it pales in comparison to the Masher's. Masher's look sick, so we'll have to pull up a picture in a little bit. It looks so cool. Probably do it right now. The Monstrosidont. All right, it gave me, I looked up images for the Borderlands 3 Masher, and a bunch of images of potato mashers came up. Perfect. Damn it, there's one that looks really, really cool. Really cool image. There. We're gonna have to look at it like this, sadly. But you'll still get the idea. This is from a hater hype video, but look at that thing, man. Huge ass barrel, like a shotgun, little slugs on the side of it. This looks wicked. Pearl grip. But that is a Masher. Like, Jacobs makes Mashers, and now they're on everything. They're on ARs, they're on snipers, like they were. Be good, it makes, since it turned from yellow to tie in so much of the story to it, to basically get rid of it. It makes no sense. I just wasn't understanding how they were gonna do it. It seems weird to get rid of explosive, but now it makes more sense. Like, it's an AoE modifier. Yeah, okay. They're always fucking with it. I mean, in one, it was so generic. It just, like I say, it was like all the other elements, you know? You'd shoot a guy a bunch, and you might light him on fire. Shoot a guy a bunch, you might get shocked, and his head would pop. I'm glad they brought the gore back from Borderlands 1, though, of course. I think corrosion's in a weird place, too. But, like I said, it just doesn't seem strong compared to cryo, but maybe it'll have more of an effect. It feels like it's getting the short end of the stick, though. Nose explosive is an element. Come on, Monstrodont, whatever. Monstrosodont. Well, that's not the Monstrosodont. I can kill that thing. Oh shit, that's it. Alright, come on, Monstrosodont. Why not do more things based on elemental synergies? I mean, synergies are going to be huge in this one because... So TVHM, it's not like the biggest deal in the world, but in TVHM, everything's either got a plus or a minus to it. So if you're like, you're using shock against a shield, it's 100% effective. But if you're using it against armor, it's 100% damage reduction. If you're using armor against flesh, 100% reduction. Using against armor, 75% damage multiplier. So like, doing that in-game stuff, like a mayhem mode or a circle of slaughter, it seems like you're going to really want to know what you're doing as far as elements and being able to switch in and out. Oh, I see what you mean. That cryo plus corrosive. I mean, it's kind of there, right? You can do, like, you know, have your shock weapon flip to your fire, and then Malawan. Malawan now has multiple elements on one gun, kind of like the Chimeras from Borderlands 1. So you could get, like, a Malawan weapon that's the perfect bandit weapon. It'll have a shock element on the alt fire, and then the fire will be the main. Borderlands 2, I'd slag everything, because people got sick of slag. I don't blame them, because it's become just so tedious in UVHM to constantly slag. Like, at least you knew how it worked. I'll be curious to see how radiation works. Looks like radiation is just basically like fucking slag, though, just better. The only difference is it spreads. Why did you not follow me? You can't fucking die, but yet you'll barely follow me. Come on, you fucker. You have no health. Yes, come on. Yes, come on, continue to bitch slap me, please. Yes, come along. Thank you. Hey, I have another. Come along. Thank you, can I have another? Swear, I'm just fucking walking backwards. This, you should have no problems following me. He's gotta be frustrated. Like, he's been slapping the shit out of me. We still have full shield now. I came back in time. Like, you're gonna get more than just your Monstrodont, German filmmaker guy. Stay in there, you fucker. Oh, God. Like, this thing's so pathetically weak. Anything will kill it. Look, it was in the cage, dude. Ah, I see. Alright, how do we shut the fucking door? How do we shut the door? That's not the Monstrant done. This thing actually is starting to do decent damage. Alright, great. It's in here. Ah, there's a button. Please tell me I can press the button. Please tell me I can press... Yo, you fucker. There was a button! Hell not to play Borderlands 2. It was doing no damage. And then at the end, it became a beast. It's ripped us to shreds. Well, that's good advice, Hyperion. Thanks for that. Oh man, we really are on the eve of the launch. Womp womp womp. We really are. I mean, it's next week, right? 100% it's next week. Yeah, Friday of next week. Holy crap, dude. Holy crap. Cannot believe we're here. Come on, this is the one! Now look, it'll bitch slap us across the map, but the second we get it in this cage, it goes Hulk mode. It takes no more shit. Come on, Borderlands 3 is being delayed. They really want to get Fallout 76 right. It's perfect. Yeah, I'm hearing pretty bad things about this raid. I don't know. Have you logged in and checked it out, Wilso? Do you have any interest in returning to Fallout 76? That just sounded like it hurt. That just sounded like it hurt. Fucking trap me all you want. I don't care. The quest is done. Guess what, you fucker? I'm gonna keep you in there. You're not even worth the second wind. You just enjoy your new life in the cage, dog. Wouldn't mind jumping back in, but Dad will grab me. Right on. I see where you're coming from. That was worth the $80,000. It was worth